How do you do?
I'm fine, thank you.
How do you do?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good day.
Good day to you too.
Victorian society, in all its glamour and books and movies, was as tight as a lady's corset. While the lower class didn't have time for etiquette and decorum, the upper class had all the time in the world to flaunt their grace. Now, me being based off the Victorian era, I wondered, what would have been expected of me had I lived in those days and actually gave a crap? In today's video, we will be going over the etiquette of a good lady. What period is the Victorian era? The name was chosen based on Queen Victoria's reign, which lasted from 1837 to 1901. The echelon of Victorian society loved to have special occasions for everything, and a dress code for each one. In terms of fashion, ladies of the upper class would most likely own, for underwear, they would have girdles, crinoline, bras, corsets, petticoats, panty, thongs, and underpants. Crinolines looked very inconvenient, by the way. They are steel-constructed cages holding women's skirts far apart. Now, in the 1840s to 1860s, the fashion sense was everyone loved bell-shaped skirts with several tiers of layers for clothing. They also had bonnets, bloomers, pantaloons, lace, cape jackets, or shawls. These were quite the rage. And beyond the 1860s, they started to have collars, cuffs, and high necks were more popularized. The waist started to go down by the 1870s, and small hats were added to the set. By the 1880s, the back of the skirt became more embellished and flaunted around, because that became the center of attention. Now, outside a lady's wardrobe, in Victorian society, the ideal woman was essentially a kind, gentle Mary Sue with a personality as bland as stale bread and as flat as a doormat. In terms of conversation, it was better to say little than too much, for if you talk too much, you run the risk of talking nonsense. You want to make friends, you say, ha, don't be silly. You want to share your interest? How preposterous. Now, be sure you look at the person you speak to, but don't stare at them as that would be overly familiar. And to be fair, staring at people for too long makes things kind of awkward, since why would I want to stare at your face unless you're anime? Also, don't be too punny. Too many puns and proverbs is a guaranteed way to make me roll my eyes at you. There were also topics you could and could not participate in, like politics and controversy. So essentially, you are better off being seen than heard. And they highly recommend you not to be yourself, as that is disgusting. As mentioned before, in the streets of good old England, it was highly recommended for women to not have a large net of acquaintances. A woman going out should also have an escort. A married man or a family member would do. Although woman going out wasn't suggested either. They were basically encouraged to be a ladylike neat, if you think about it. If a lady wants to talk to a man she comes across in the streets, she'd have to offer her hand until he greets her. And in a carriage ride, the man should be the one to sit with his back to the horses, and he cannot sit next to the lady unless he's a relative. Naturally, there are more areas and details we could go over, but in terms of things that interested me, there is the battlefield, which we call the dinner party. Messing up during this could be a social faux pas. The hostess has to do their best to not offend anyone during this. When people are entering a room, it is customary for all to stand up to greet them, and it's recommended to arrive 15 minutes late, which I also read in another book about a lady's etiquette. Reason for this is, this gives the host more time to put the final touches. There's also a procession that needs to be planned, and people come in pairs. Widows and single people were awkward to pair up, and you don't want to offend people by giving them a wrong pairing. Now to a topic you might like, courtship. I covered marriage in the medieval ages in a video, But now it's time to go over courtship in the Victorian era. Not much has changed in the fact that people didn't have to love each other. There could be other motives in play because of finances and security being at stake. It was recommended for girls to be in town during the season to partake in social events. The season starts in January and ends in June. This was essentially the marriage market, and they had to find a husband within 3 seasons before becoming less desirable. I did not verify this last bit, but if they fail to catch a partner in these seasons, they may become a spinster. Now, if a man were to be interested in a woman, he shouldn't be alone with her, and they need to be chaperoned by her folks. He would have to arrange a meeting to court her, and that meeting would take place between 3 and 5 p.m. The final topic that I'll go over today, and hopefully I've given you a good basic idea on what was expected from Victorian ladies. This topic is marriage. Common sense, but the gentleman should ensure the lady is fond of him and won't be running away screaming when he proposes. He should then seek her papa's blessings before making it official. After that, they would need to settle the finances. The whole dowry, trust, and other vocabulary terms I don't even remember anymore. I mentioned in my other video if you'd like to check that out. The terms and process is similar to this too. It was also lewd for this couple to even touch each other's arms. So should you ever travel back in time, don't you dare do such a scandalous thing. And now with a slight bit of knowledge crammed into your beautiful, delectable brains, I hope you readers and readers have a mighty good day. By the way, if you are interested, I have new merchandise based on my redesign. Are you into notebooks? Oh boy, you can make that your death note. Are you into mugs? Oh man, you can mug people with that mug. What about stickers? You want to stick that onto that body you just found? Perfect, I love a good murder. Lastly, there's also mouse pads. I have nothing emo or edgy to say about that. They're a mouse pad. What about pillows? You wanna suffocate that person? Go for it. Also, I am not condoning this action. It is a joke. You don't wanna be horny anymore? No problem. I'll just get this hammer and... What about me staring at you in shame? Perfect, I can do that too. Have you felt the urge to dab at your opponents? Or what about telling Corona to get wrecked? We have that too. I hope you enjoy this merchandise if you choose to support me.